I want to share a little bit about a game jam I recently participated in. If you don't know what a game jam is, it's an event where individuals and teams design and develop a complete game within a specific amount of time. Also, there is usually a theme. The one I participated in was the Enigma Game Jam, hosted by Matt Asplund. The theme was supernatural, and it took place over a period of 2 weeks. I've done weekend-long game jams before. I'm glad I did, but I had to lock myself in my office for a whole weekend to do that. Since this game jam was taking place over 2 weeks, it felt more approachable and wouldn't take me away from my family and my responsibilities. So I looked at my schedule for those 2 weeks, and even though I had to travel for work for a few of those days, I figured I could at least make something. So I signed up. Okay, so spoiler alert. I'm going to walk through the story in the game loop. If you haven't played the game yet, or you're interested in playing the game, go do that first, and then come back. Sandy's last song is a ghost story centered around the church. Sandy was married to the minister of the church, and she found out he was being unfaithful. Then, a lot of bad stuff happened. Until recently, the church was boarded up, but real estate investors from California bought the property to create a brand new neighborhood. You, the protagonist, decide to explore the church and the surrounding area. Along the way, you encounter a lot of strange things. The game has a small game loop, where if you figure out specific notes on a piano, it will conjure Sandy's ghost. It has two endings. You see one if the ghost gets you, another if you survive. So what were the results? There were 56 total entries. My game placed 16th out of 56 overall. This was my first ranked game jam. That means people in the game jam, and really anyone that played the games, can rank them. While I don't really care about the rankings, it does make you reflect. There were four separate ratings that made up the ranking. Theme, visuals, audio, and overall. Mine placed 8th for theme, 8th for visuals, 14th for audio, and 16th for overall. There were a lot of ghost-oriented games. I thought the games that weren't about ghosts might rank higher for being more original. I personally rank those types of games higher. So I was surprised to get 8th for theme. For visuals, not bad. I spent a lot of time getting the lighting just right to create a creepy mood. I also adjusted all the textures to have the same size and general look and feel. I didn't spend a ton of time there though, so I'm surprised I ranked that high. For audio, I'll admit this one hurts the most. I spent so much time picking out and setting up just the right sound effects for this game. It's a core part of the gameplay. After all, a haunted piano is the centerpiece of the game. Maybe it's the sappy piano music at the beginning that tanked this one. Overall, I'm generally happy with how I ranked. It's not bad for my first ranked game jam. I didn't do this for the ranking, though. I did this to force myself to create a game in a compressed amount of time. I'm happy with what I created, and I may do more with it. While the voting was going on, I spent a few days tweaking the game and uploaded a new version. I hope you'll take a look. If you do, let me know in the comments or on Itch what you think. I'm always open to feedback and constructive criticism. Okay, until next time. Bye.